Good morning. Thank you. Thank you for being here. And Governor Hobbs, thank you for having me. This is an opportunity I take great, not just pride, but take quite seriously. I was born and raised on the border, and I know too well the sufferings that go on both sides of that border. I will just say this simply, that I've said all along, this is a federal government problem. And for the state to have to take it on, for each county to have to take it on without funding, without any resources, without any housing or food or health care for these migrants, that's just not right. And to put that burden on the counties hurts me specifically, hurts my team specifically, because those funds could go to hiring more deputies, to hiring more corrections officers, to giving those raises that are needed greatly by my team and others out there in the communities. So it does impact us in a way that's not just financial, but more importantly, humanitarian. We all know that we can put all the uniforms you want on that border. We can put the sheriffs, highway patrol, our border patrol agents, 1,500 troops from the federal government. But we also know that's not the solution. The solution lies in the halls of Congress in Washington, D.C. And I think we all are getting a little tired of the partisan politics on such critical issues as gun violence, immigration, you name it. It's time that we hold those we elect to office accountable, that we make them stand up and do something, make an effort to reach across that aisle and get things done. Governor Hobbs, I thank you for not just your pragmatic response, but more so for your humanitarian belief that this is a humanitarian issue, and we need to deal with it as such. So thank you for having me. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.